don't have any good cards to play against Blockade. You know, if I get Red Scare Purge and Blockade it here, I actually can't do anything. This is a... It'd be safer to not put 4 in West Germany. I mean, I'd put like 2 there. Put 1 in West Germany and 1 in France would be safer, I guess. Oh, you know what I just realized? Oh, wait, never mind. So, now that I know that I'm not getting Red Scare Purged, I know that I've got a card to throw in Blockade now, so, oh, don't put the China card. Interesting. To get the China card this early, but that is pretty ugly. I wonder if I should have just put more into West Germany and just taken the chance that I don't get the Red Scare Purge and Blockade combination, even though both of those cards could definitely be in his hand. I mean, there are still 22 cards in the draw, and only had 8 in his hand at the start. I mean, how likely is it that he's got both of those cards in his hand, and he headlines for Red Spirit Purge? I don't know. I mean, if he's got them both in his hand, he's probably going to want to headline that Red Spirit Purge most of the time. Or play it on his first turn. I guess it's still a pretty low percentage. You could space Nasser this turn and then hold Vietnam and space that next turn. I could coup Turkey right here. Like I like Afghanistan better. line duck and cover for 2 points, and he wouldn't be able to Kutai land. Good space, Vietnam and AI war and hope decolonization until next turn, possibly. To remember to overprotect France here because De Gaulle is getting reshuffled at the end of this turn. And we haven't seen Korean War or desalinization yet either. probably can't compete for Europe domination, but I still want to overprotect France here by at least two. It's got Europe scoring, CIA, Marshall Plan, UN intervention, IP war, and Red Scare Purge in his hand, and two other cards. If the headlines would scare Purge, it hurts, but not that bad. We gotta also remember that Blockade is still in the deck. And again, I have a bad hand against the Blockade event.
Chesswood, who's I guess he can't really fool Iran at the beginning because he's got CIA in his hand with no China card. Oh, he does have UN intervention, though, that's true. I could try to do a realign right here. In some of these countries that got installed. And I kinda like that, honestly. It doesn't come through that often, but wow, it's huge. This next space race box is something that's also extremely important here. I kind of want to space actually in second thought. Trying to hit this next space race box. With that glass, with that NATO blaze basically waving the white flag in Asia. About taking Mexico this turn and also getting some presence in Africa like Algeria. I'd end up just holding the Fidel. If he doesn't event blockade this turn. gone, I still kind of want to poke one into Egypt, but I guess that's not as high a priority as stuff like what's more in South Africa over here. Southeast Asia also. Vietnam Revolts is in the deck, so if I want to take Vietnam, I gotta pick three there. Yeah, on second thought, I guess Egypt isn't really that high of a priority here. We've got tons of scorecards coming up. And Middle East is going to be going for a long time. God, Argentina's pretty huge right here.
Really, really looks good. I'm gonna do that before he starts getting adjacency here. Puppet governance is also quite good. The problem with headlining the brush war though. So it's a coup of the country that I just brush war. On the other hand, I guess he's got good coup targets anyway. Panama's not such a bad target either, really. Puppet governments, obviously I want one in Nigeria. I'm also really afraid he's got South America scoring in his hand because he's playing pretty aggressively there. That second one there, just in case he coups Colombia.
take an 8th and a 10 here. Oh, my bad. I just realized I had my mic off for like this whole time, I guess. I mean, not off, but sitting over here too far away.
Maybe I can hold the AI war and then Camp David events will come off and they'll turn into a better card for me. I feel like right now I should space.
I did it again. I'm holding the microphone too far away. Yeah, I should hold the AI war, I think. Okay, I gotta remember to keep the microphone over here. Almost wonder if I should play the AI war and hold Fidel. I really, I don't know, I kind of feel like I messed up on my last turn there. Do it like this, I guess. Well, I've got a pretty good realign setup. I guess I should go for it. Venezuela's only at -1. I think I should go Cuba again. And I gotta remember that blockade is still out. Lone Gunman is way too dangerous with the We Will Bury You still out. He's definitely going to headline We Will Bury You a significant percentage of the time right here, and that's instant loss for me. Oh yeah, and I have to show my headline first, so that's even worse. This Lone Gunman really sucks. It's gonna be hard to get rid of this card. Must have a really bad hand. Oh yeah, I keep thinking about the blockade, but I don't even have West Germany. I'm so used to having West Germany as blue that I keep thinking that the blockade event is a threat, but it actually doesn't do anything. It's almost better for me to event Quagmire here. South African Unrest is such a bad card. It's better to play it on Quagmire than it is to event it. And I can only space one card. Arab-Israeli War isn't that great for me either. So even if it takes me two rolls, but if it takes me more than two rolls, it's a total disaster. I better just space Quagmire. Salt negotiations headline. I could pull out a card like Colonial Rear Guards. And it would help me get rid of the Lone Gunman as well. He's protected against Panama Canal. I kind of like this Salt Negotiations headline here. And take Colonial Rear Guards. I guess another card that's pretty good is Brush War. Nigeria is really susceptible to that. Of course, ABM is always good too. I mean, actually, maybe ABM is better than Colonial Rear Guards, maybe, on second thought. Even with the Salt Negotiations penalty. Yeah, that's what I should do. I should pull ABM. Also, could have headlined Southeast Asia, and I know that he can coup my Southeast Asian countries because of the DEFCON, but he still has to take that minus one penalty. It's a pretty interesting hand I have here. I certainly have a good shot at Africa domination. And arms race event is pretty good too. Even though I have the plus one realign here, it's really not that amazing because he's just got so many ops. Cuba, on the other hand, is a pretty good realign. Nigeria is a decent secondary if I end up realigning with a multi-op card. So his most likely scorecard here is Central America scoring. Of course, I don't want to focus too much on Central America and neglect the scorecards that are in my hand. ABM Treaty on Zaire is a pretty big priority here too, to get Africa domination. And playing Lone Gunman is a pretty high priority too. Even if I have to show him my whole hand, it's not that big of a deal. I really, really desperately need to get this out of my hand. I've also got to remember that some of the cards in next hand are going to be cards that are reshuffled at the end of this hand. Not very many, but some of them. I guess I should probably coup Zaire with this card also, and then if it's not successful, I always can try it again with the ABM treaty. I kind of want to realign in Cuba also. I mean, if he's still going for Central America and he knows the scorecards I have in my hand, then he's almost surely got Central America in his hand. If I do end up controlling Zaire, I have a pretty good realign on Angola, too. Even with the minus one from salt on the coup, it's still more efficient to coup a one stability with that lone gunman than it would have been to put one influence down. I feel like I should just give it, you know, I got such good realigns set up here. I mean, I gotta be like 99% sure he's got Central America scoring in his hand. Okay. And I got a good realign here. Sort of good. Even after that, he's still threatening to control Central America again. Oh, man. I don't think that Vietnam is still out there. Not sure if I should put one in Vietnam before I score this. Might even think about using ABM Treaty on Mexico instead of Africa now. Of course, I could just use ABM Treaty to jam 4 into Cuba right now. I mean, doesn't that kind of make more sense, really? Need to remember that I can't miscount my cards here. Got an extra one because assault negotiations. I probably should have spaced liberation theology on this turn, but there's just too much going on. I'll just have to hold it, I guess, even though I really don't want to. You know, if I discard Liberation Theology and get a scorecard, I lose, so I'm gonna have to not discard here. I know eight of his cards. He's got South America scoring, OAS, Camp David, Grain Sales, Nixon, Bear Trap, Ussuri River Skirmish, Muslim Revolution, and one other card. So his hand is pretty horrible, and he's got South America scoring. I feel like I might be able to get Central America domination here. I mean, I could take two off Mexico, two off Guatemala, and have him completely removed from the region here, but I'm not sure if that's best. It's going to be really difficult for him to play his hand here. He can't space two up cards anymore, so he can't space Grain Sales, can't space Nixon, can't space Camp David, but he could play it off on the Bear Trap and space Ussuri. His hand's pretty bad, but it's not unplayably bad. Even so, I don't really feel like I can fight for South America here. wonder if his last card is Middle East Scoring. If I can hit a space roll and event one small step, I might be able to get to that fifth space race box first also. Well, I get the chance to play We Will Bury You here. Even though it gives up 3 points. That's tough. It was also extremely unlucky for him that South America scoring came out this turn, because it won't get reshuffled now. Oh, I guess I wasted that one in Jordan. Maybe I should just dump Central America scoring here. Nah, I still feel good about this. He's got such a bad hand. Well, that was pretty huge. Okay, what's my best play here? I really wanted to headline Africa scoring there, but if he's got Che, he could knock out my domination with it. Maybe that's being too much of a scaredy cat again. I guess I probably should have just gone for the Africa scoring here on second thought. I'm kind of under time pressure too. I need to hurry up here. Yeah, I ran pretty great in this game. I don't think there's any way he can avoid the War Games victory at this point. Really curious still what I should have done at the beginning of this game, because I'm really not sure still what the best play was. Anyway, thanks for watching, everybody. I'll jump into the chat after the game. Well, that is to say, after the game ends in real time, but 30 minutes before the game ends on Twitch.